Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Grigsby's War in the East. Now, I have covered this game before, but I did terribly, and according to Steam, I have about 23 hours on this game. Oh, I'd like to say so, but I do imagine most of that was spent, kinda with this in the background. Every time I play, I always end up seeming to be busy with something else. So, anyhow, we're gonna pick a scenario, and we're gonna choose to bugger it up. We're gonna go with the true campaign, just because I kind of want to give it a go, and I suppose there's more freedom due to the fact you have a larger space really to work with. So we're gonna put this on so we can see the enemy hexes. So this is the situation in 1941. The date is the 22nd, and the war is just about to begin. So we have the different army groups over here. So, we'll call this Army Group North, Army Group Centre, Army Group South. That's good to know. I do feel that we should concentrate on the South, though, and try to strive the Caucasus. Can we find a map mode to show anything like oil? I tell you, I really don't know that much about this game. I get the basis of how to play, but I'm not that good. Right, victory. Okay. Soviet decisive victory. Access to... 290 victory points. Okay. Weather. So weather's good right now, that's nice to know. Reinforcements. I tell you, a lot of this is going to be a learning experience, so if you guys have never played a Grigsby's game, then I'm sure you guys will enjoy this as well. So we have our rails on here, I'll explain that in a moment. Unit modes. Not entirely sure of that one. Okay, that tells us if they're isolated. Factory locations, okay. So we can see where factories are. That's good to know. If we take a lot of the factories, we can try and reduce the amount of production that the Soviets will have. And there's quite a lot of factories in the South, actually. So that's a really interesting thing to take note of. Though, we have Leningrad over here. Do I want to go for Leningrad? No, not really. It's a hellhole and the weather's going to be atrocious. I mean, the weather in Russia is atrocious anyway, but the further south it is, the better it tends to be. And there's not really much in the south compared to the north. You can see most of the Soviet strength is kind of concentrated about here and about here, which makes a lot of sense. Now it's a funny thing as well, so I should have had the fog of war on. I shouldn't be able to see all this without, well, we'll make do with this. I'm sure somebody will give me an idea of what options I should have. But as, oh, we don't have perfect information. We have near enough decent information. I suppose you could call this, some intelligence work before the war begun. Okay, so let's go for... We could go for air reconnaissance. That could be quite handy. As you can see here, this is the limit of our aircraft. Or we could go immediately for bombing the airfields. I might go for bombing the airfields, actually. We'll go for that one. So we're going to have the AI run this. Now we're going to have our airfields, so you can see all these highlighted out here. We're going to have our Air Force, our Luftwaffe, and that of our allies. Strike of the Soviet airfields and try and destroy as much as possible while they're still on the ground. So you can see here they lost 115 fighters, here they've lost 35 fighters, defending was 11 fighters, attacking was, well, 39 and 69. They lost another 105 fighters here. They're going to lose a hell of a lot of air power right here. And that's how I think we should start off the campaign. So, I mean, we do have the... Pink marshes over here, I do believe that's what they're called. So, I think that's what we should try and use as our wedge. I mean, this is absolutely horrific terrain. So if we can try and make a pocket here, then that could be quite good. That's actually quite an interesting idea. If I use armor, we could try and have a pocket in the Ukraine over here. I think Kiev somewhere around here. I mean, if we try and get it to this river line here, down to Crimea, we could try and trap them in a gigantic pocket. If we trap them in a gigantic pocket, then we could try and annihilate them. We'll see how it goes. It's going to be somewhat difficult to keep track of the overall war plan while we're zoomed in. That's going to be the issue here. We always need to keep our eye on the goal at large, and that is the conquest of the Soviet Union. Or at least enforcing our will upon the Soviet Union. I also do have Grigsby's War in the West. But I swear, I don't know, it's just something about that. I just can't really work it too well. I think it's the notion that I seem to think that the German Wehrmacht, is still, well, competent in the later years. They just don't have anything. Okay, so we just bombed the hell out of that. So can we find losses? We can. Oh, well, this is order of battle. So you can see here our total numbers. So we have 320,000... Well, not 320, 3,207,003 men. 32,868 artillery pieces, 5,377 pieces of AFV, so armored fighting vehicles, that's tanks, as well as like half tracks and stuff like that, armored cars, etc, etc. You can see here our allies are contributing. The Soviets do have some significant manpower. We are kinda close. We might have a little bit more with our allies, but yeah, it's kinda close. Though they do have an incredibly good armored fighting, well, vehicle pool. They have about 21,000 here, which is quite impressive. Now, how good all of this is, I do not know, but the Soviets definitely did have a hell of a lot of armor. Okay, losses. Here we go. Right. Air losses. So we can see here, we've lost about 5 planes. We lost 2 fighters and 3 level bombers. Well, the Soviets have lost 1,491 planes, 1,166 fighter bombers, 141 tactical bombers, 153 level bombers, 31 reconnaissance. That is some huge losses. You can see here they lost 51 in the air, but they lost the grand total of 1,422 on the ground. Now that simulates the fact that we're attacking the airfields, they're still all on the airfields. It's a surprise attack. The first few turns, I do believe, of this campaign is a massive advantage to the Axis to represent the surprise attack. Right. So we do have a hell of a lot over here. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and talk about the rail lines over here. So, the way it works in Grigsby's War in the East is basically all these rail lines here are green. That means that we can use them and supply runs along them fine. However, once we start getting into the Soviet territory, we're going to have to start changing these rails over. The Soviet rail is a wider gauge than German rail or European rail in general. So the German engineers would have to change this, and this took time. It really limited the amount of supplies that could come through as well. Now we have here the Baltic Rail Zone. I do believe that rail in this area is of the German gauge, or close enough. I'm not entirely sure. But elsewhere we're going to have to change all of this. So I think if we can identify the best supply lines and start to work towards that, then that'd be great. Okay, Kizhinev. Where's Kiev? If we can find the large cities, then I think we'll be better off. Right, so we have Kiev over here. Yes, Kiev over here. There's going to be supplies. Excuse me, I still have a bit of a cold, so my throat and voice is a bit weird. Yes. Right, so we do have major cities along the river here. If we go for the objectives, victory locations. Is it going to show me? No? Okay. It's one of these buttons. I can't remember which one it is. Info screens, no. Air doctrine, okay. Percent required to fly. Ground support, attack, ground support, reconnaissance. Actually, we should do some reconnaissance, so we're going to do that now, but so we can have our Air Force take off and just get some reconnaissance going. At least then we can see here. Right, there we go. They've taken some pictures. Still going on. Okay. So the terrain here is very interesting. We have... yes. Well, you can see here, Soviet rail. I think it said that. Yeah, Soviet rail. Now, compare that over here, we have Axis rail, is what it's going to be known as. So we have the marshes here, the Pripyat marshes, or whatever you want to call them. And we also have Brest-Litovsk. Now, Brest-Litovsk is a very nice city. However, if we go over here to map information, fort levels. You can see here it's a level 3 fort. So it's going to be very difficult to take. And we can also see there is a 22nd tank division, a 42nd rifle division, and a 6th rifle division. We can also see their combat values. They have 5 combat value, 3 and 3. While over here we have 12, 8 and 12. So our troops are a hell of a lot better at this stage. So, it's going to be difficult. I really do need to try and stick to my plan. So what we're going to do is bring up Bandicam here. And I'm going to borrow this. I believe I saw Agrippa Maxentius do this, or was it Pew Pew Perchu? I can't remember who. But we're going to basically draw out the lines with Bandicam. It's fantastic for that sort of thing. I mean, we have, like, Breastlet of Osk over here. We have the marshes over here, so we need to avoid all this. Yes. Okay, so get rid of that. Yeah, there we go. Ah, goddammit. Oh well, we'll just change the camera. So what I'm thinking is if we can try and... I don't know, try and cut these forces off here in this sort of pocket here. It's going to be hard because they are going to have the supplies from the coast, i.e. the ports and etc. But if we could try and cut off these forces here, but I think our best chance would be to try and sweep in from here and cut off these forces. That would be the most achievable objective, really. Considering we have forces here, but these forces here are Romanian, and they're not as good as our forces over here. So if we can use these forces as our hammer and these forces as our anvil, I think we'll be off to a good start. Yeah, so we'll have to have our armor sweeping down here, try and cut off supply lines. Which should be quite easy. It's not too far straight like this. Okay, so we're going to hide that again. Boom. And, yes, right then. How do we want to do this then? 3-4. We could go for Tarnopol. Or Tarnopol. We have a rail line that links up to here. So if we go for something like that, we can try and cut them forces off. There will be these forces as well, but it's going to be hard to cut them off due to the fact that I'd have to go into the marshes, and I'd rather not go into the marshes. I can use my infantry here, my infantry divisions, to push them. So I think that's what we're going to have to do. Okay. So we're going to use the infantry to begin with to push through. Right, we have some security forces here. They're not going to need anything strong to take them out. So I'll just use one of my infantry divisions here. They should retreat. There we go. They've surrendered, actually. That's fantastic. Right. Now, I do want to make sure we have a nice corridor to work with. Defender... Oh, right. Those forces have held. That's not good. That's not good. I'd rather have that just given away. Okay, we use the other divisions here and try and push them again. Good. They've retreated. That's what I need. Yes. Okay. Bum 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 bum. Move our divisions forward. There we go. Now I'm going to try and open up a corridor here. I want a nice large corridor. So I'm going to move that force there. I'm going to take this fresh division here and I'm going to push it forward. Now we can also see here. Right. When we have the HQ selected here, you can see these units glowing in blue, and these units here, these are the ones that are associated with it. Also, we're going to need to talk about supply. I can't remember how you show supply easy. Somewhere, possibly. Nah. Well, basically, when you have your supply here, it's called supplying from the railhead, basically. So you can imagine this division is not far from this rail here. So the supply is really efficient. It's going to get there a hell of a lot easier. I think we have it somewhere. Right, our vehicle pool over here. This is where I wanted to find. So we have our vehicle pool over here. So we have 251,000 vehicles at the moment. So that represents trucks, motorcycles, horses and carts, whatever you want to call it. It's all there. Well, I'm going to go with motor vehicles to start with just to represent the idea a lot more efficiently. Now, say we have this force here. They're going to be resupplied very efficiently. We're not going to really need to use any of these vehicles. However, if we had a division out here, they're far away from our railhead, so we'd have to use vehicles to supply them. And that's inefficient, you're burning fuel. Yeah, that's kind of how it works. Okay. So we're going to push forward here and, yeah. Force them to surrender, that's good. Okay. I want to open up a corridor for my armor. That's what I'm looking for. Ah, so you can see here we have, let's see, supply need. We have more supplies than we need right now, so that's good. That shows you how efficient our supply is right now. We can also change the color, which is pretty cool. We'll have, we'll push forward here. And then get that guy in here. Lovely. Probably not the most efficient thing, but oh well. Now then. So we have our armor here. We can try and push forward, but I would like... Well, let's push forward a little bit. Let's see what we're working with. Oh, also, these black little dots over here, they represent towns. So you can see here's a town. And when you take towns, you can find supplies and stuff like that, and it's generally quite helpful. Okay, so we could come like this, and that would cut off the supply lines for these guys, but obviously the rest of the Soviets would just pile in there, and it would be of no use. Let's just push this front line. Oh, they held. Ah, you little buggers. Little buggers. You can also see here we have 185 artillery pieces, 16,000 men. A division, really. And this is quite a nice panzer division. You can break them up, I just can't remember how. Ah, here we go. Right, so this is one of our rail engineers. Okay, so I'm going to... rail damage, no. That's not what I want. There we go. Okay. So you can see here, these red ones, these mean that we can't get that supply there. It's the Soviet rail and therefore doesn't work. So, I'm going to get you. I'm going to have you move over here. And then... at least I should think so. I don't know why it's turning off when I select. That's, not good. Well, what should happen is I should be able to change this rail over, but what we'll do then is move you back to about there. Okay, so I have two panzer divisions here. I'm going to move this guy forward. So we have the 13th, and we have the 11th. We'll move the 11th and the 13th together. Then I'm going to grab... Right, these motorized aren't ready to move as of yet. That's a shame. We also have the 14th, so I'm going to take the 14th down here. So right about here, we have a huge amount of power. That's a lot of armored fighting vehicles. So if we can take a look here at our division, we can work out what's actually in it. Vehicles, yep. Okay. Supply details. Yeah, there's a hell of a lot of intricacies to this game, I'm not going to lie. Right, morale's 85. So we have armored cars. We have... I wish you would set to... well, sorted by type. So we have some panzers over here. We have a few Panzer IVs. The Panzer IVEs. 44 of these Panzer IICs. 23 Panzer IIIs. And about 42 Panzer IIIHs. Yes. So that's pretty damn good, and then we have support, so that's all kinds of things like that. 150mm howitzers. Yeah, it's really interesting that you can take a look at this and see exactly what's made up in your division. It's really handy. So, what we can do is we could assign something. So we have different support units that we could assign. So we have self-propelled flak. Now, I believe self-propelled flak may, in fact, mean the 88s. I do not know. Exactly, we could take a look at that. Support, self-propelled AA is what I'm looking for. There we go. Ah, there we go. Now, that is the 20mm flak. 20mm flak, okay, and then support. What I'm hoping for is in the future that could be... the 88s, and they were incredibly good for anti-tank duties. So I have a shitload of power here, so what we're going to do then is we're going to use it to try and annihilate some of these divisions. What do we have here? We have an artillery brigade. Wow, that's absolutely nothing. Absolutely nothing. Get them out of the way. There we go. They've been routed. Lovely. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to break these divisions up. And so, let's see. Right, if I just move you forward, I might be able to break you up. Okay. There we go. So we split it into three corps over here now. So in each is 5,000-ish men. Now what that allows us to do is to cover a lot, well, a larger area. Obviously less troops for a larger area. So we can move over here. I didn't mean to move over them. I'm not gonna lie, that was a mistake on my end. Might as well build them back up, but you get what I mean. Okay. Now what we're going to do is use them to kind of form a line. God damn it. Ah. I boogered up my line. Oh, I'm terrible. So you need three of these to build them up into division. You can't really combine two of them, it doesn't really work like that. Okay. Now, your HQ is all the way over here. So what I can do is I can bring it forwards to about here. Then they will be in, which increases their supply, efficiency, and etc, etc. Right, we have you over here, but you're kind of far away. So instead of having you burn your fuel, I'm going to have you move via rail. So we can do that. He'll move via rail. As you can see, he is not burning any of his supplies. So we'll take you off the rail. There we go. Whoops. Have this back on. Way to go. Ah, there we go. Okay. Then we can have you move a little bit. Actually, you can't really move, can you? No. Ah, fair enough. But he'll be there and ready next time. Excuse me. Right. So I kind of mucked that up because I'm such a noob and I'm trying to explain what I'm doing at the same time. What do we have over here? We have some absolutely horrific forces, cavalry, and they're all brigades. That's an interesting thing. So it's brigades, but it has 12,000 men. That's almost a division strength. It's odd on that end. Yes. Okay. They don't have any movement. That sucks. Right, so none of these guys can move, fair enough. Okay. Right. Bum 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 bum. I have this division over here, I could move. Right. So can you attack? You can't attack, okay. Let's try and push this line forwards a little bit. If I can get to this rail line, then that might be handy. What do we have over here? We have Koval. Now that is a town, okay. Yes. If I can have these guys push to this line here, so I'll spring up Bandicam again. Didn't mean to take a screenshot. Yeah, so if I can have them push up to here, so like that, that's going to be easier. Because, I mean, these marshes are here, but it's not going to matter too much because they're not going to go through them, really. It's terrible, it's crap, it's just awful. Hide that again. Okay. Oh, you don't have any... Do you not have any movement? Oh, wrong mode. There we go. Okay. They actually halt? No, they surrendered. That's good to see. Yes, so the idea here is to surround as much as possible the enemy. So you can see here we have support from these airfields. Yeah, attacking fighters and bombers helping us out. That's really important as well. I'm going to have to keep moving up these airfields as much as possible. So over here we have 119. And that's level bombers. Well, here we have fighters, so that's good to know. Excuse me. Ah, terrible. Absolutely horrific. Absolutely haram. Right, remove of these airfields. It does use a lot of supply, but we do need them at the front. Ba ba bum bum ba ba bum ba ba bum. There we go, we forced them to retreat, that's good. Dun 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 dun. So you can see here their morale. Now I've got it over here, so this is soft factor, experience, supplies, fuel, units attached, non, right, morale. So their morale is pretty bad right now, so we should be able to break them. Yeah, they've routed, that's great. All we need to do is wipe out these units. So what I could do is I could close up here, and that unit is moved all the way over here. Okay. So what we'll do then is we'll move up over here. If I had any more movement, I could break that up, but we won't need to. Excuse me. Okay, they've retreated from the town over here. That's great. Move here. Attack once more. Units have shattered. Great. It's been shattered. So that means it basically it can't be put back. Could move you there. That's good. I do that too much. Actually, we'll move you there. We'll put that together again. Move you there. Have you attack. Right, the defensive forces have held. So you can see here their attack has really gone down. I mean, this one's at 18, that one's at 6, that one's at 5. Yeah. Okay, so these guys have good morale. What I'm trying to do then is to push this line, and if we push that line, we should, once we have the Romanian forces in play, we should be able to try and trap these forces over here and annihilate them. At least that's the idea. Of course, that's going to be the idea in the north as well. I think what we're going to do is, well, strike for Riga. But then kind of ignore this area, because if you look at this terrain, it's pretty bad. It's marshy, it's pretty awful. You don't want to go there on holiday, basically. But if we can strike, well, I think we should go for Moscow, really. It's going to be a hell of a hard fight, but if we can go straight for Moscow, I mean, if we go for Leningrad, we're going to have the issue here. So I think what we might want to do then is, use infantry and establish like something of a line like this, because then we'd have army group center excuse me, to help back us up as well. So what we could try and do then is use army group north to try and shield our advance from the forces in the north like Leningrad and etc, and try and strike for Moscow, because our armor will have a great time going across these open plains, like especially over here. Oh, armor has a perfect time. It's beautiful. I mean, this area here is known as the European Plain. And you can guess why. Okay, we get Balnet back down here. Righto! Use you. There we go, they've retreated. Ba ba bum bum, ba ba bum, ba ba bum. Come on, give way. God damn it, they're going to be a pain in the ass. Okay. Rifle division, that's been routed, and then a border. Yeah, there we go. So what we're going to do is we're going to surround this division of infantry and have them capitulate. Bum-ba-bum-bum. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now I'm going to break this unit up. Excuse me. God damn it. I guess I can't. I can move to here, but I can't move around. It's a shame. So we'll build them back up again, and we'll... I may bring you down here, but even then you can't move that far. Ah. We do have this armor.